Here I am, Your Excellency.
Take this, Doc. Most gracious sovereign, tonight on the eve of your sublime birthday, all your loyal subjects here in the far west joy in sending you affectionate greetings.
Hear, hear!
And assurances of our devotion and esteem.
Bravo!
Most cordial, heartfelt good wishes.
In fact, many happy returns of the day.
Yes, but dress it up a bit. You know, you ought to be able to compose a telegram to the Duke by now, I guess.
Trouble is, for the longer he lasts, the harder it gets.
Olga! Olga!
What is the matter now?
I told you before, I won't have you flirting with any man you meet.
Excuse me.
Oh, you live here long, can't you?
Olga! Olga! dear, poor Cromwell. Did you ever see such a jealous husband?
No, if any husband ought to be jealous, it should be your Excellency.
Me?
Shouldn't it?
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing.
He's talking nonsense, Excellency. Everyone knows the Baroness is the very model of virtue.
Yes, indeed, just an innocent child. I'm a very lucky man, you know.
Not now, Camille, not now.
But Flossie.
Shh, wait till we're alone. What are you doing?
You won't allow me to say it to you. So I've written it down.
I love you.
Oh, darling, there you are, my dear.
I've been here all the time, chatting with our guests.
Of course, I was the perfect hostess. Eh, de Rosioff?
Yes, indeed.
And apropos of that, my dear, you will remember Madame Gilvary is arriving at any moment. You will be on hand to greet her, won't you?
Certainly, I will. Don't worry.
Did you say Madame Gilvary? The Patches widow?
She's coming here tonight. Yes. She's on a visit here to Paris, so I invited her. Clever move on my part, wouldn't you think?
I see what you mean. Your Excellency is interested in the widow's 20 million. Sir.
20 millions? Oh, sapristi! 20 millions? Oh, very nice.
And she's an unusually pretty woman, too.
A pretty woman with 20 millions? Oh, it's just too good to be true.
Furthermore, her money is in the bank of Pontrevedra where it must remain. If she decided to marry a foreigner while she was here, we'd lose the lot, and that must be avoided at all costs.
Just fancy, my dear, the daughter of a poor tenant farmer, up to his eyes in debt. She marries an elderly banker, and he leaves her a widow in less than a week.
That's what I call the act of a perfect gentleman. And now I suppose this simple country girl had become a smart society woman.
But at least she calls a spade. And she's not given to keeping her mouth shut either.
Oh, and a very pretty mouth too, if I may say so. Ah, the double's over, ladies and gentlemen. On with the dance.
20 million, eh? Monsieur Sandrios.
Yes, Nico?
Do you intend to marry the widow? Oh, decidedly, if you have me. She won't.
Oh, why not?
Because, most decidedly, she will have me. Oh,
we'll see about that, shall we?
We certainly shall.
These two are up to something. We've got to nip it in the bud.
Who do you think it is, Your Excellency?
All of your poor niggers. The widow, of course. She decided to marry upon the building. We'd lose a cool 20 million.
May I remind Your Excellency that I'm a bachelor?
I'm not surprised. Don't take fruitless remarks while I'm trying to think.
No, Your Excellency.
What we need is someone young, good-looking, experienced, attractive to the ladies. If it wasn't for the fact that I'm already married myself. Oh, I got it. Count Danilovich.
Count Danilovich?
Yes.
What about Your Excellency?
He's the very man. The man to earn 20 millions for the fatherland.
And he's never earned anything in his life.
Then it's high time he did. He starts tonight. Find him. Bring him here at once.
I'll try, Excellency.
And be quick about it. Madame Gilvary will be arriving at any moment.
Count Danilovich.
And I must talk to you, Alonso, and you must listen to me.
No, Camilla.
But you must, you know I love you.
It frightens me to hear.
towards the end.
Come in, it's just an infatuation, and I shall really have to cure you of it. You don't mean half you say to me, now, do you?
I mean every word. You're done the light of the world for me.
State of affairs. Once in a lifetime, the fatherland needs so many candy palms.
Oh, but I have found him.
You have? Why did you say so? Where?
At Maxine's. What faces, girls, Excellency? Oh, what faces? What fingers, Excellency? What? What have you get on the balcony? Ooh.
Oh, yes, well, that you keep your mind on your work, fingers. Did you give him my message?
Yes, Excellency. I said the fatherland needed him and would he come to the embassy at once.
Right. And why isn't he here?
Because, Excellency, he has his head under attack.
Under attack? What the devil for?
Just open up. He said he'll be here in a quarter of an hour.
Good. See him informed the moment he arrives. I must give him his instructions.
Yes, Excellency.
The whole future of the fatherland depends upon him.
Yes, Excellency. I won!
Getting you married to somebody
company with her.
John Lotto, just sit out of it, huh?
But I thought you wanted to
come away at once.
Listen, my friend, tomorrow you must all come to my house. I will give a party for the entire cultivating colony in Paris. What do you say to that?
Bravo, madame, bravo, splendid. What a child of nature you are. Just like my attaché, Count Danilo Danilovich. He is also completely unspoiled, a genuine Pontevedrian, irrepressibly gay like yourself.
Count Danilovich, whatever made you mention him?
Oh, not that I thought for a moment, though, certainly not.
The Count and I, it was nothing, nothing at all. It doesn't matter.
What was nothing?
After all, why should there have been anything?
My dear madame, I have no idea why there should have been anything. I thought you said there was nothing.
So there was. Nothing. Nothing at all.
I see. So there was something.
Ah, music! Madame, may I escort you to the door?
Oh, no, please, madame.
Delighted, madame.
Delighted.
Oh, I tell you, I am going to marry the women.
And I tell you, so am I.
But I say you shall marry her, Camille. I want you to your heart.
Oh, Florence, dear.
You'll be very happy. I shall remain a respectable wife.
Very well. To please you, I will marry her. The sooner the better.
Well, I didn't mean as soon as that.
Exactly what I need.
is all about?
I'm not quite clear myself, Count.
You never look it.
But His Excellency did mention something about earning 20 million.
Who? Me? Earn 20 million? Oh, I could spend 20 million just like that, but earn them? Oh, no, my friend.
Perhaps you'll tell him that.
Agus, I haven't had any sleep in about the last 4 nights. I've simply got to get some shut-eye now.
Oh, very well. I'll announce you later.
Just a little bit later, say 3 or 4 hours?
That's very comfortable if you care to try it. You can snore there to your heart's content.
Oh, you've got a heart of gold, Agus.
Like Madame Glavarek, huh?
Madame Glavarek. And is she here?
She is indeed. All the men are in love with her. Millions.
Well, here's one who isn't. Oh, and Agus, I never snore.
You can't, Daniel. Good night.
Good night, Agus.
What's the name of the one with the golden hair and the outline?
Clo, clo, do, do, ju, ju. Clo, clo, mother. Fru, fru.
She'll never be able to remember all her names.
No, don't do.
But I must find it, Camille. It's all very well for you, but I'm a respectable woman. If only you hadn't been so foolish as to write I love you on it.
But I do love you. I've told you many times.
Yes, but to write it on a fan. Suppose my husband found it.
Let's have another look.
I told you not to call me.
Oh, it's you, Daniel. You haven't seen a fan anywhere, have you?
No, I haven't. Anyway, I'm on a rescue. Go away like a good fellow.
I must have left it in the ballroom after all.
It must be somewhere. Wait, I'm coming with you.
I wonder, Sandriosh, as soon as I have broken off a little affair with a married woman, I intend to marry the widow. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, my dear Vicomte, but when I have done precisely the same thing, I shall do precisely the same thing.
Quiet.
You are tempted by her millions. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Yes, they tempt me, and I am ashamed. They tempt you too, but you are not ashamed.
Oh, quiet! How dare you shout at me?
But you shouted at me!
Fortune hunter! Money grubber!
Quiet! Oh, there's no peace in this place.
Oh, gentlemen, I've danced so much. I'm completely worn out. You must let me have a little rest. Really, you must. Please, I will rest later. There, money director?
that certainly doesn't apply to me. Furthermore, I resent your attitude, madame. It only goes to show that as far as you and I are concerned, you don't understand the situation at all.
On the contrary, I understand the situation only too well. Shall I explain it to you?
Please do.
We met a long time ago.
Quite true.
In London, on Tom Fisco.
And you?
Well, good thing at least I know.
It's over and done with now. Too bad.
I worried and pressed a lot.
I'm sad.
Well, now I can give the jot.
I'm glad.
It's over and quite forgotten.
On his farm, and it belongs to my wife. I know it does. I'm sure it does, and it proves that she's unfaithful.
Nonsense, my dear fellow. It could belong to any of the ladies here tonight.
Oh, my dear.
You arrived at the precisely the right moment. This fan here,
it has
the words I love you written on it.
Really? How unusual.
It belongs to you, doesn't it, my dear?
No, it doesn't. I've never seen it before.
Say it's yours, or he'll kill his wife. But I'm certain it is, darling. Won't you have a closer look?
So it is. I recognize it now. Thank you so much, Monsieur Cromwell.
And who might have written the words, I love you?
Who?
Oh, Dad.
And who else but my dear husband?
There you are! Who else but my dear husband? They are hardly a husband.
Well, if it's like that.
Of course it's like that. Don't think anyone else would, do you?
Very clever.
It set my mind at rest. If you'll excuse me, I'll go and find Olga and say some loving words to her. She's certain to be flirting again.
Thank you, my dear. Give me the fan and I'll retire discreetly to Madame Trouble.
Oh, I can do that.
Oh, no, I would dream of troubling you. Ah, Daniel. So you've arrived at last.
As you see, Your Excellency.
Apparently. Seven of hearts, in fact.
Oh, very well. If you must.
I want it everywhere, but I...
Ah, my dear Comte de Razon, would you mind escorting the Baroness and the Champagne? I have a very important business this time.
Certainly, Your Excellency.
The fan has been found.
Splendid.
Yes, but my husband has it.
Not so splendid.
The whole thing's far too risky. You must marry immediately.
Very well. I'll propose to her tonight.
I didn't mean it immediately at all, but...
Let me see, Daddy Love. How long have you been with us up the embassy?
Oh, it's years too long now. It's about 4 months.
You better sit down. What have you been doing with yourself exactly?
Nothing. Nothing at all. I have absolutely no talent for work whatsoever.
I suppose you gambled a bit.
A bit, but I've always lost.
And no doubt you've had quite a number of affairs, eh?
Just a few. Your Excellency knows how it is.
No, of course I do. And I suppose they've left you broke.
Not exactly, but very near. It's amazing how much money goes into a woman's hand, especially if it's a very small hand. Your Excellency wouldn't be...
Ah, but yes, I would. Now, look here, Danilo. You seem to know women.
Oh, just a bit, I suppose.
It'll do. You're just the man for a delicate mission.
Provided it entails no work.
Oh, it would be a pleasure.
In that case, you couldn't find anyone more talented or willing.
Good. You have to get married.
Married? I thought you said it was going to be a pleasure.
So it will, when the lady has 20 million.
20 million? Madame Glavani? No, never. I'll make any other woman happy, but Madame Glavani, not for a million million.
Why, I will not. She's a very pretty woman. And do you realize if she marries a foreigner, our beloved fatherland will be bankrupt?
Ah, so that's it.
My boy, your country needs you.
Well, if it's only a matter of making sure she doesn't marry a foreigner, I'm sure I can arrange that somehow.
How?
Oh, simply by eliminating anyone she might take an interest in, except a Pontevedrian, of course.
Which brings us back to you.
That is quite out of the question.
Confound it! Why?
Because... Well, because I'm a man of principle. And my principles are... Fall in love, often. Get engaged, then. Marry, never.
How's it done with the ladies to choose a partner? Who gets the eye of the willow, I wonder?
A dangerous moment, this. All right, I can take a hint. You want me to go to work now?
The fatherland would be great.
Rejoice, dear madam, I rejoice. If you will marry, if you stay, if you will pass with me, if you should so decide, I love you. Thank you.
want an embryo.
Thank you, Your Excellency. Later on, I'm providing something more, how can I put it, more Parisian.
Indeed?
If I may tell you in the strictest confidence.
What to do with that?
Well, then, I have arranged a little surprise for Count Daniel.
For Count Daniel?
I believe he's very fond of the nightlife and goes to a place called Maxine's, which unfortunately I don't happen to know.
On which I do happen to know, even more unfortunately.
So we have arranged to have the garden transformed to look like Maxine's. And we have engaged a sextet of grisettes.
I did engage in real live grisettes. Extremely real and very much alive.
Do you know them all, Magus?
Very well indeed. Oh, as very well indeed as anyone could on my end, as it's all of it.
Oh, I'm sure His Excellency will do something about that, Magus.
Oh, I'm quite sure I shall. But not quite what you think.
You won't forget that what I've told you for the moment is strictly entre nous.
Entre nous, madame.
Thank you, Excellency.
So, she is interested in that animal after all. But he's, by the way, not under a tap again, I hope.
No, Excellency. As a matter of fact, he doesn't want to come.
What?
He said that as far as he was concerned, the party could go to blazes.
To blazes? Did you tell him this is an official occasion and he has a duty to the fatherland?
Yes, Excellency. He said the fatherland could go to blazes.
That amounts to treason. High, in fact, treason.
I pointed that out, Excellency, but he said a flock of wild horses wouldn't reckon here.
Why, of horses don't go in flocks, you fool. They go in hordes or schools or something.
Yes, Excellency.
So he won't come, eh?
No, Excellency.
We'll see about that. Ah, Daniel, so you've decided to honor us with your presence after all. What the deuce have you been up to?
Oh, arranging a few removals, that's probably.
Well, you've been wasting your time.
What do you mean?
Why don't you keep in closer touch with the mastermind? I've discovered who the real menace is.
Oh, who's that?
Count de Rosio.
Come in.
The widow's definitely interested. We've got to find some way of eliminating him. Some secret in his past, perhaps.
There's a secret in his present, Excellency.
Oh, well, that's something. What is it?
He's in love. With a woman!
Well, aren't we all, more or less?
A married woman, Excellency.
Ah, now that was different. Who is she?
Well, he couldn't exactly say.
Oh, fuck all of you. Sure, I'll have to find out myself through diplomatic channels. We must confront them with this married woman, coerce them into doing the honorable thing, and that'll be that.
But what is the married woman's husband going to think about it?
Whew! I shan't have any qualms about making him a cuckoo. Oh, look, there you go. There's my wife with the Rosio now. You know, my wife seems to have a great deal of influence with our young Frenchman. She'd be the very one to get to work on him and find out the name of the married woman he's in love with. Now, isn't that a good idea? Vegas. When you get the moment, Her Excellency, I shall be shortly requiring a confidential word in her diplomatic ear.
Yes, Excellency.
In the meantime, Daniel, you can help me make discoveries through the proper diplomatic channels by doing a little quiet sleuthing on the side. Perhaps this could give us the answer.
The lady's hat. I love you, written on sir, inside. In Camille's handwriting. Now, he was looking for a fan just the other night.
Whose is it? Well, that's the whole point. Find the owner of the fan and you find Camille's lady. Madame Gromov, perhaps?
Olga? Oh, no, I hardly think so.
Oh, well, anyway, make a few discreet inquiries for me, will you? No, I must go and see my wife. She must get on very close terms with the Rosio without today. No sacrifice is too great for the fatherland.
I love you. I think any man could be foolish enough to put it in writing.
Why, Count Daniel, I am surprised to see you.
No, why?
Oh, well, I thought for tactical reasons you'd probably go on avoiding me for a little longer.
Ah, yes, we're enemy powers, aren't we?
At war. I seem to remember it was your idea.
I seem to remember that the feeling was mutual. Anyway, I have been on a reconnaissance, and I think it's about time for a little skirmish.
A skirmish? A good soldier doesn't skirmish. He attacks.
Ah, that's exactly what I'd like to do.
Then why don't you?
You'd immediately remind me that you're a defenseless woman. It's woman's oldest form of defense.
Oh, Daniel, must be quarreling. So tell me.
I agree. I hate it too. That's really why I've been avoiding it.
I remember a time when we used to enjoy being together. Do you two remember when we used to drive through the park in my carriage? And those two used to call me.
He's going to marry somebody else. The widow.
Sembleyock?
Sembleyock?
Oh, the wretch! Thank you, Danilo. So, he's going to drop me and marry the rich widow for her money, is he? We'll see about that!
Well, 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 this obviously isn't Olga's in that case. So I wonder who the lady of Camille can be. Ah, Sylvia, could I have a word?
Certainly, Danilo. What is it?
Tell me, Sylvia, haven't you lost something besides your heart. Something which can be written on and then folded up.
What on earth are you talking about?
Oh, don't be afraid. I'm very discreet. I just thought you ought to know that your gentleman friend is going to marry somebody else. The widow.
Cascada?
Cascada? Oh,
the mean creature! I won't let him. I shan't let him. I must find him at once. Where is he? Oh, thank you, Danilo.
Well, well, well. Sylvia and Cascada, eh? Well, what a fascinating fact you can find out by just dropping a few hints here and there. Now, who on earth can this belong to?
What a pretty, pretty girl.
Oh, sure, it couldn't be hers. Yes, it is, isn't it, Proskovia dear? Tell me, dear, do you know what's written on it?
You tell me.
Oh, just three little words. I love you.
At last, at last.
At last? Oh, it is hers.
Did you guess, Danilo, or did you know?
About your secret romance?
Yes, indeed, yes, indeed.
Oh, yes, indeed, yes, indeed.
You must have sensed it all along.
Of course. Sensed it? Sensed what?
How very dear you are to me.
Me? Now, listen, Proskovia, dear, you must have made some mistake.
Of course, Yonio.
Oh, Proskovia, dear, please be careful. Look out, your husband.
Bashful boy. I shall count on your discretion. For a while.
Forever?
So, renounce the widow immediately, or take the consequences. I warn you, Sandriosh, I am a good swordsman.
And I warn you, Cascada, that I'm an even better marksman, so you're an
quiet!
Quiet yourself.
Oh, don't mind me, gentlemen. I have to speak to Madame Gavari about you anyway.
About me?
About both of you. About you first, Cascada. I have to inform Madame that you are to be challenged to a duel by Bogdanovich.
Bogdanovich?
Yes, you see, he found out about you and his wife.
Oh, good heavens!
That rather clears the way for me, I fancy.
Oh, I'm afraid not. You see, I have also to inform Madame Glavari that you are to be challenged to a duel by Cromwell.
Cromwell?
Yes, you see, he found out about you and his wife.
Oh, dear.
I trust neither of you will do anything rash.
Rash? That's what I've come out in.
The secret is always to keep a cool head.
Cool head? It's a good pun all. I am made to deliver this card to Madame Gavari immediately.
Oh!
Goodness, that's something I don't have to worry about. It's a problem, so I'll grant you that. Generally, though, it's the husband to blame for not treating his wife properly.
But how do you treat a wife properly? Can anybody tell me? Does anybody know?
No, don't look at me. I'm just a man. And there's one thing a man never has been or never will be.
I've heard before.
pretty women in general, do you understand? Not you in particular, so you needn't go feeling pleased for yourself.
Oh, I hate you.
Wow.
from the ministry. What is all this nonsense?
I believe it's in codex music.
Then decode it.
Your Excellency, the ministry would be obliged for your promptest.
By what?
Your promptest reply by wire 320 melons.
Melons? What do they want with 20 melons?
Cannot hear the minister's favourite drink, Excellency.
Well, if you can get through 20 of them, there's nothing wrong with this digestion.
That's why he's going as the Minister of the Interior, Your Excellency.
Idiot.
Give me
millions, you said, Mr. Blackburn, millions! They want an immediate reply, but they won't get it because this is wording very carefully, and I have to think. Diplomacy is based on delay and tactics anyway. Ah, Danilov, you just had an urgent telegram from the ministry about the Glavari melons. 8 million. I need your help me draft the reply. What time is it?
I have the king's diary.
You never have. What's the time?
It's either 7:45 or 7:45, Excellency.
Well, be here. You too. At either 20:00 or 8 o'clock sharp. If we work in the summer house, we won't be disturbed there. Look, Danilov. My wife's still talking to the Rosyok. What a smart girl, eh?
Oh, very smart. Very smart indeed.
Oh, they're heading this way. Come along. We don't want to disturb them. She may just be wheedling the secret out of him.
Then we better let her get on with her wheedling.
Yes, yes, go.
It's no use, Camille. My husband knows you're in love with someone. He didn't ask me to find out who it is. Surely you can see this before. Now, at once.
If it must be so, at least give me a keepsake. Something that will remind you of your love.
A keepsake?
Why, look, there's your fan.
Oh, thank heaven. You should have this.
Thank you.
Sommerhaus.
Oh, oh.
Thank you.
get engaged early, but marry never. But if you do, and lots of friends, and when you're born, seek consolation.
How dare you?
A wife needs male society. The spice of life is still variety.
But he's daunted back.
correct.
Oh, not so correct, I hope.
You'll see for yourself, Excellency. They'll be on in a moment.
Oh, just a minute, just a minute. All this is supposed to be for Count Danilo's benefit. What's the use of his dear?
He's being brought back, Excellency.
Ah.
And you can be sure he'll get a warm welcome from his girlfriends. By the way, the ladies of the chorus will be 7 strong, not 6. One of the guests is dressing up and joining in the cabaret.
Oh, not Madame Prescovia, I hope. She make a grisly concert.
No, Excellency. It happens to be your lady wife.
What? The Baroness! Consent!
By special request, Excellency. And I assure you, for one performance only. Ladies and gentlemen, les grisettes!
Let's go.
you'll oblige me by keeping it hidden.
I nearly forgot, Excellency. Another express telegram for you.
How is it you always forget the express telegrams, Negus? I get them quicker by carrier pigeon. Damn, things in code again. Gentlemen, I have to ask you to join me in a special conference.
What? A conference? In the middle of a party like this?
The matter is pressing, urgent, vital, says so in the telegram. Decode it. Not you, you fool! We find ourselves sent with an order for 2,000 mangle wurzels or something. You won't need it.
Oh. Loss of Glavari millions would mean state bankruptcy inevitable.
Oh, there's only one thing for us. We must appeal to Madame Glavari's patriotism.
Oh, hear, hear.
If she has any regard for the fatherland, she mustn't marry anyone with a pond of it.
Hear, hear.
Of course, Daniel, you must speak to her, find out what her true feelings are.
Hear, hear. Who? Me?
Yes, you. Appeal to her. Tell her that we must know her intention immediately. The matter is pressing, urgent, and...
Michael?
Exactly.
Very well, I'll do as you say. If Madame Glavari marries de Rosillon, I shall join the Fallen Legion.
Bravo! I'll give you a personal recommendation. Come along, gentlemen.
Again.
Then don't. Just tell me, why do I blacken the face? Was
such a way.
No, she didn't. Not in the least. She only stepped into the breach at the last moment for another woman. A married woman, naturally.
Who was it?
For that, Your Excellency, I don't know.
It was most certainly Olga.
Oh, my dear Kromov, whatever makes you think
she that... She flirts with every man she meets.
Oh, well, in that case, I'm sure she wouldn't compromise herself with any one in particular.
All right, dear. Our merry widow isn't going to marry Camille Virozong after all.
Oh, thank heaven.
Excuse me, Excellency. This fan is found in the summer house.
Oh, that fan!
Yes, it's the one I gave to you, Danilo, for safekeeping.
Yes, I lost it.
In the summer house. Why?
You had a rendezvous with Olga?
Oh, my dear fellow, now I'm
really... Don't start the whole thing over again. My dear sir, this isn't your wife's fan at all. As a matter of fact, it's mine.
What? Madame, consider yourself divorced.
Madame Ferrari, I am free, single, separated, divorced.
What? All at once?
And I take this opportunity in the name of the fatherland for asking you for your hand in marriage.
Oh, thank you, Your Excellency, I'm honored. But I'm afraid you do the fatherland no service at all by marrying me. You see, my late husband's will lays it down that if I remarry, I lose my entire fortune.
Is this true? You have no money?
Not a sou.
Oh, now I can say it then, darling. I love you.
Oh,
I love you.
Yes.
He marries her because she has no money, yet he wouldn't marry her when she had. The man's a dead loss.
Oh, not at all. On the contrary, you see, my late husband stated that I lost my fortune the way we married because it becomes the property of my husband.
Oh, darling, I'd have married you even if it had 40 million.
Oh, well, then everything is all right, then. Except this. Madame, why did you have to admit that was yours in front of everybody?
Because, dear, I knew what I had written on.
What you'd written on it? I'm a highly respectable wife. Oh, my dear, I apologize. I didn't know that.